So I guess that's what I'm doing here. So I said, hey, Mr. Snowman, thanks for your time. I'm feeling so much better now. What's yours is not mine. Now life is looking rosy and I'm feeling just fine. I said, hey, Mr. Snowman. Hey, Mr. Snowman.
Keep wild.
Hey, Mr. Snowman.
Radio 2 Smart Speaker Sounds app at 88 to 91 FM.
BBC News at 1 o'clock. This is Catherine Cracknell. The second nurses' strike in a week is underway in England, Wales and Northern Ireland. Train drivers have confirmed another walkout in the new year. And Argentina's World Cup winners receive a hero's welcome as they fly home. Around 10,000 NHS nurses in England, Wales and Northern Ireland are striking for the second time in less than a week. They're demanding a better pay offer after the government said it would stick to a rise of around 4%, which was recommended by an independent body when inflation was much lower. Ida is a nurse who's at a picket line in central London. She believes the strikes are necessary.
We don't want it to go on for any longer, but if we have to and there's no other choice, then there's nothing else that we can do but continue to strike even though we don't want to.
The Health Secretary, Steve Barclay, said the government wasn't willing to reopen negotiations with health unions about pay, but would discuss other concerns.
We're keen to talk. We're engaging with the trade unions. On pay, we have an independent process, and we have accepted that in full. And, of course, that comes on top of the extra prioritisation of the NHS last year. But we also, alongside that, need to focus on patients.
Unions representing ambulance workers are meeting ministers this afternoon to discuss patient safety during strikes, which are set to begin in parts of England and Wales at midnight. They say industrial action can be avoided only if there's an agreement to talk about pay. Appearing before the Health Select Committee, Rachel Harrison from the GMB union said paramedics felt they were being physically prevented from doing their jobs.
Our members are tired of going to work every day and in some cases spending the whole of their shift sat on an ambulance outside an A&E department with the same patient. We've had examples where our members have clocked off at the end of one shift to return the following day to the same patient being on that ambulance with the crew they'd left them the night before.
Another rail strike has been announced for the first week of the new year, adding to the travel disruption already facing people returning to work after the Christmas break. Members of the train drivers union, ASLEF, will walk out at 15 companies on the 5th of January. The RMT union is already planning action on four other days that week. Theo Leggett has more details.
Industrial action has already crippled the rail network for much of December, and the situation in early January is expected to be just as bad. This week, an overtime ban, industrial action short of a strike, is causing serious disruption on some networks, including major commuter lines into London. The walkout by train drivers on the 5th of January will be sandwiched between two further 48-hour strikes planned by the RMT. ASLEF wants more pay for its members, who it says have not had an increase since April 2019.
A woman has been charged with the murders of two boys aged 2 and 5 who were found dead at a house in East London on Friday. Cara Alexander, who's 44, will appear before magistrates later today. The high street bank TSB has been fined nearly £49 million for a disastrous IT switchover in 2018. The regulator, the Financial Conduct Authority, said the bank's failures had been widespread and serious. Here's Kevin Peachy.
The fiasco that followed TSB's attempt to move data to a new computer system affected the day-to-day lives of millions of customers. Branch, telephone and online banking all went down. People were locked out of accounts. Among the problems caused, removal vans standing outside homes as new owners struggled to complete purchases, wedding day payments delayed. While this fine is significant financially, the reputational damage to TSB had an even greater impact.
Jeremy Clarkson's newspaper column, in which he said he hated the Duchess of Sussex, has become the Independent Press Standards Organisation's most complained about article. More than 17,500 complaints have now been made. The piece was removed from the Sun's website yesterday at Mr. Clarkson's request. Argentina's World Cup winning team has arrived back on home soil. They were greeted by thousands of fans who waited up all night to witness their return from Qatar. Katie Watson reports from Buenos Aires.
There was mass celebration on the streets on Sunday, but today is expected to be an even bigger event, with the government declaring it a public holiday. The keenest fans didn't want to miss their arrival on home soil. There were celebrations outside the airport. And today, crowds have already started to gather here in the centre of Buenos Aires, where the team, on board an open-top bus, will later head towards the obelisk, which has been the focal point of match celebrations.
And the weather looks set to be a windy afternoon in northwestern areas with blustery showers. Elsewhere should be mostly dry and bright, but a few showers are likely in southwestern England and Wales. Temperatures reaching 8 Celsius in Edinburgh and Belfast, 9 in Manchester, 10 in Cardiff and 11 in London. That's the BBC News at 1:05.
Good afternoon.
Listen live on the BBC Sounds app.
In this hour, worries over a children's gaming platform called Roblox, and also developers maybe not being allowed to use fake grass anymore.